guys, welcome to Gara Gaming TV, and welcome to the beginning of Mafia 3. So, we've done one, we've done two. This is the third and final Mafia game. I actually haven't played this one. I had it before on disc, as so far back I'm going. When it first came out, I got it on disc. I played half an hour, maybe, hour tops, and I just never ever got back around to playing it. So, me and all you peeps out there, we are going to rack on and gonna start a new game. Now, I've already started a game, but the resolution was off by a country frigging mile. The graphics were terrible, so I had to set everything up. For some reason, it didn't auto set up. Well, I hope we've got everything good now. Mafia 3 takes place in a fictional version of American South in 1968. Sought to create an authentic immersive experience that captures the turbulent time, including depictions of racism. We find their racist beliefs, languages, and behaviors of some characters in the game. Adorant, is it? I believe it's. Man, that's the music done. I'm gonna get a copyright hit now.
City with traditional southern values.
I'm gonna turn the game on.
What he was willing to do?
Visit the historic French Ward and enjoy local cuisine at one of our five-star restaurants.
Killing them wasn't enough. Lincoln Clay was using them to send a message.
Or spend the afternoon in the bayou and take in its natural splendor.
Sal Marcano had no idea what he was going to unleash.
New Bordeaux. Safe. Family-oriented farm. Make it your next vacation destination.
Is what, this New Orleans?
This city survived the War of 1812, the Civil War, and God knows how many hurricanes. But when Lincoln Clay went after the mob, he inflicted more damage than all the wars and hurricanes combined.
Ooh, I love a good revenge story.
Lincoln's mother abandoned him in 1947, a couple of years after he was born. His mother, I heard she was Dominican.
Oh, the James Bullard. Priest, first priest retired.
Not that it mattered. Back then, if you look black, you black. Same as today, I suppose. He stayed at the orphanage until 1958.
When did you meet Lincoln Clay?
1966. I was running black ops out of Laos on behalf of the CIA. He was loaned out to me via joint CIA-DOD task force.
He was a quiet boy. Good boy.
Thanks for switching
the
present.
Hearts, the Bronze Star, and the Distinguished Service Cross. He served his country with honor and distinction.
After the city closed the orphanage, he fell in with Sammy Robinson. Sammy ran the black mob over in Delray Hollow. I can't say I approve, but often colored boys didn't have a lot of options back then. Boys like Lincoln, ones who've been abandoned. They're always looking for a home. Always looking for a place to belong. I think he thought he'd find it in the army. Thing is, once that's lost, you can never get it. When he returned from the war, Lincoln ended back up over at Sammy's. And Now, Sammy owed the Italian mob a whole lot of money. And he needed Lincoln's help. It's a damn shame what happened. It breaks my heart.
Still say this is the craziest goddamn thing I ever heard. Using real money to rob the feds.
Well, hell, man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there.
Is everything we need to burn?
Yeah, that's it. I grab the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here. Keys in the other room. Grab them so we can get the hell out of here. Hey, man, grab those keys.
Still not sure about leaving him like this.
He came through with the truck, just like we asked. Even greased his partner to make it look good. If you got doubts, why take the chance? We should get going. You got the keys, so you can drive.
Come on, let's get the hell out of here.
Come on, Lincoln, we burning daylight. Take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses. Ah, that poor fuck back there. He ain't got no idea what he's in for.
What was his cut? 5%?
Thereabouts, but not like he'll be able to spend it. Feds will be watching his every move for the rest of his life. Probably be better we just whacked him.
If I learned anything in Nam, always a good idea to dangle someone out there. Use them to get everybody's attention, and you just slip away.
So answer me this. What's the craziest thing you saw over there?
You don't want to know.
Hell, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Oh, Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh? So come on, you going to answer the question or what?
We on the coast of Quang Nai. Evacuating the civvies where Charlie overran everything.
Okay.
Getting them on the medical ship. This woman walks up. She got a baby in one hand and the leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops her, tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water. MP goes ape, tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says to him? She says, I can only...
The fuck you doing? Whoa.
There they are. She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Hey, man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were going to tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, God damn.
It's not a fault. But not like you think. The conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day, you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day, everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
That better have been one delicious fucking pig.
Alright, so I missed a wee bit of when they were talking and the thing, because I had to go and deal with my youngest, and he'd walk up. And I forgot I'd muted the microphone there too, so we're all back and going now. So, the city looks as detailed as the second one, anyway. Lots of bridges, lots of rivers. Handbrake doesn't crank on as we go. It's very, well, lit, isn't it? There's still lots of people around this hill. Body grass, they've got masks and stuff on. Looks pretty well detailed, doesn't it?
Guards at the reserve probably won't be too keen on you waltzing around with that piece of yours.
I'll just leave it under the seat.
Really wibbly wobbly this steering wheel. Okay, then.
Let me see if these forges are worth a fuck.
Holy shit, look at that.
Some of these fellas might get a little rough with the language and...
Well, I ain't never been called nigger before.
I know, but I'm just saying, if I go along with it, ain't nothing poison.
Ain't nothing poison.
The only thing I care about is getting our hands on that money.
How much money are we looking at, like?
Say something about being hot. That's when we make our move.
All right.
Federal Reserve. Holy shit.
Here we go.
Put your IDs up the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
The fuck's this shit heel doing here?
Affirmative action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet.
Huh. Where are we at?
You can follow me. As for you, go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burning room. How much y'all bring in?
$238,546. Small bills, mostly.
I'll let Miss Gale call up to your office when we're done. She'll confirm the delivery. Appreciate it.
She'll confirm the delivery. Off we go. Off the sound is okay on the game, I'm really
check that scattergun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on the way out.
Buying rooms down in the cellar. This way. I ain't seen y'all around these parts before.
Y'all's over in Georgia for a while. He just got out the service.
And my cousin's been trying to get on here for over a year now. Was in the Navy for two tours, got medals falling out of his ass. Government tells him thanks, but no thanks.
That's a crock of shit if I ever heard one.
Sad day when a God-fearing white man can't get a job. But ain't your nigga who staggers in his hide on the spot.
Well, I don't think that's a shame we have here.
You bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
Fuck you! Christ, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that much gold.
That Washington's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back. It doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense. Here we are.
Wow.
Put those bags on the table there.
Some of the movement's a bit janky.
Figured it'd be bigger. Gets the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck. That's some heat right there.
Used to use coal for it, but a year or so back we switched over to oil. Maintains a more consistent flame.
Here's some guy come around the house trying to switch me over to oil. God, that guy was an asshole.
We need to move. Danny and Ellis should be coming up any time now.
All right, give me a second. Right, you take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting rough on us.
I know what the fuck I'm doing.
Bounce.
We've been renting out. Called over there last night. Told them I wanted to sell it. Told them they needed to be out in 2 weeks. And the man, his name's John, starts laying into me, saying the lease gives them the right to a 30-day notice. That's how we supposed to find a new place in 2 weeks. So I tell him none of that's my goddamn problem. It's my property, and I'll do with it what I please. And if it brings up that fucking lease again, I'll use it to wipe my ass and make it me. Not only that, I know he's friends with a couple of niggas, and they go over there at night and play cards.
Good night. Weapons, menu, hold, mouse middle. Quick swap, page on hold. What's the weapon page? Page up and page down.
This place ain't gonna rob itself.
Well, if you still roll your mouse, that's not too bad. I don't like X being crouched, we'll change that to control.
I hope this combination skeletor got us is legit.
We all got to shoot over how this place, won't we? Oh,
I'll be damned. Alright, go for it, Godzilla.
Loving his haircut. Holy shit, all that cash.
Fucking shit.
It's beautiful. Alright, I'm gonna take care of this room. You see what you can get from outside. Once these boys punch you with that drill, we're gonna start throwing this down.
Well, that's so much cash. Oh shit.
Damn it! You triggered the fucking alarm?
Shit, I didn't notice this cage was on a different system. All right, we're gonna hold off the guards until Danny's done drilling. Hey, you're gonna pull this off.
Get on this stuff. How many rounds in this thing? I love how this spinning run. If you use the controller, no, I'm not using the controller, no. That's just for driving.
Only way we walk out of here is if we get the weapons stored in that armory. Bust the door open. I'll watch our asses.
Need ammo. Come on, open it. Hurry up.
Damn thing.
took a couple of hits. Okay, right, so expose the lock. Move the mouse until the cursor is in beans on the left level. Okay, this is new. Pull the lock, press E. Okay, that's a bit weird. Not even a light on mechanic. Okay, we are on to the teeth.
Hit him with the smoke. Shit, man, these guys ain't fucking around.
Face way worse than this over in Nam. Little smoke don't mean shit. Stay close to the vault, watch for the drill. I'll deal with these assholes.
What the hell's he doing? Oh,
well, Sammy had men all over the place. And one of them worked at a cleaner's and stole the uniforms Georgie Marcano and Lincoln Clay wore on the day of the robbery. Another one was a janitor at the Federal Reserve, and he provided a rough layout. The robbery of the Federal Reserve was timed perfectly, and none of it would have been possible without the involvement of Sammy Robinson, Lincoln Clay, and the rest of the black mob.
Detail is pretty good. Right.
You just come from Vietnam?
That's right.
I was a Marine in the Pacific. You can take it from me. Just because you're home doesn't mean you're back.
Oh.
You understand? People around here, they don't get it. Never will. Keep your ass out of trouble.
That car.
Sorry I'm late. Got caught up crossing the bridge.
Don't worry about it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my stepbrother, Lincoln Clay. You seen him? He used to get ticked off if you were even a minute late.
Kiss my ass.
There he is. How was the trip?
Being how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it, it was fucking great.
Well, cutscenes are back on.
The old man.
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever then.
Brother, you have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis. She's looking good. Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your car.
All right, come on. I'm ready to go home.
set a route, press that to open the map. Select the mission on the map, press X to view chapters. Action. Back to my objective. I'm gonna drive to the. Oh, listen to it.
So Sammy's doing alright.
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed? What if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
I won't.
He'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama Hell, you know how he gets.
I like the mirror that's all open. jaywalking. Police awareness. A police will attack if you commit crimes. Act suspiciously or break traffic laws within range of police awareness indicated. I believe this.
You remember Marty and Ron Langford?
Sure.
They moved up to Empire Bay a year or so after you shipped out. Started Empire selling Bay. Weed. They call and ask me if I want some. I say sure. Free money as far as I'm concerned. Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line and says they're moving into heroin, that they're looking for a partner down around these parts.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I never told him about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about. I ain't said more than three words, and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses, and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood. We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got any money to begin with.
That's cool.
Fucking around aside, heroin's pretty serious shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man, I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
There's no way Sal's gonna go along with that.
Georgie like says photo mode on this now. I think I'm knocking the audio down anyway. Down. Okay. Keep dialogue up. Well, yeah, that goes.
Keep his old man from fighting out. We'll steer clear of the hollow in Frisco, just selling the fresh water.
That seems a bit better.
George's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man. George is a cool cat and all, but heroin ain't the kiddie
pool. Oh, I need to turn that off. I can feel vibrations in there. Controller, that definitely has to come off.
Come in on it with us. I bet he'd agree to a three-way split.
I don't know. I kind
of need to
figure some things out.
Yeah. All right.
The texture on the roads aren't as good as in Mafia 2, to be honest. The buildings look quite good. The vehicles look okay, but the road texture is definitely not as impressive.
I was thinking we can go to this new club in the French Ward. Maybe double date it.
Well, who the hell am I gonna go with? Your great aunt Beatrice?
Oh God! I ever tell you I accidentally saw her without a shirt once? Oof. That was the droopiest, nastiest tits I've ever seen. They were like two sacks of potatoes with nothing in them.
Yeah, like that was a fucking accident.
Hey man, fuck you. I was damn lucky to walk away from that one. Anyway, you'll go with Regine.
Look at the tie deformation.
Regine?
Believe me, once you see her, you're gonna want to dig right in.
Tie deformation.
Matter of fact.
She got half the guys in the hollow sniffing around, asking her out. Turns them all down. She's only got eyes for you, Lincoln Clay.
Copter from Amistad over here.
Fuck you.
Wait and see, man. One look and your pecker's gonna pop right out.
It's a pity the text quality was only high. There's no epic or anything like that on it. Boo.
You
Illegally park. Be right.
Look who I found panhandling out in front of the train station.
Pleasure, man.
Welcome back, baby. Boy, I send you to bring Link on Clairehorn. Not the big nigga who ate him.
Well, shit, old man. I finally went somewhere they knew how to cook.
Welcome home, son.
How are you? I'll be better once I get some of that shine in me.
I always did love corn whiskey. I would like to make a toast. My father used to say that the real worth of a man came from the mark he left on the world. When Lincoln first told me he was joining the military, I was against it. Too dangerous, I say. Let those people fight their own war, I say. But then I realized Lincoln needed to go out and make his mark. And that's precisely what he did.
Uh-huh.
And so... so proud of you. Por Lincoln! Bienvenue a la maison!
Por Lincoln!
I don't remember any of this.
Good to see you.
You're so good.
Nice seeing you, Lincoln. Oh, I kept you in my prayers.
I really appreciate that, Father.
Now who wants to get shit-faced?
It's hard to explain what it's like.
2002. So when was this done?
Elation. Fear. Guilt. Imagine being trapped in a dark room and there's no way out. And every fear, every nightmare you ever had is in that room with you. And there's no escape from any of it. And then one day a door opens and you're free to go. Just like that. The thing is, you made your peace with your terror and your fear of death. And now part of you is afraid to leave it behind. But what choice do you have? Every soldier has to walk through that door, one way or another.
Man, whiskey's going to hoit in the morning.
Hell, man, just sleep it off. The room's the same as you left it.
I'm going to take the basement.
The basement? Why the fuck you want to crash down there?
I'll see you in the morning.
Man, that wall must have really fucked you up.
Oh, Playboy bunnies like in the last game. Look. He means a dog racing on me. Around here. Saving, so that's what I'm going to call it, guys. That's it. We have started the final Mafia game. Hopefully you can enjoy this, guys. As I said, this is actually one that I haven't played before, so it's going to be interesting to see where this goes and how it, if or how it ties into the last one or any of them. Hopefully it does, because They've all had a pretty good tie-in so far, so. Yeah, thank you for watching, guys. If you liked what you've seen, please, please, please give me a thumbs up. Please hit that subscribe. Please hit that wee bell, ding-a-ling-a-ling. Most of you that watch are not subscribed, guys. It doesn't cost you anything. It is free. So just hit it. It helps me out a lot. If you want to help support the channel some more, guys, there's a link down below for Gary Gaming TV merchandise. Hoodies, masks, mats, t-shirts, usual sort of stuff. You can see it on screen in a minute as a sample. If you want to help support the channel but do not wish to purchase anything physical, there is also a link for PayPal. Everything goes back into the channel, guys, so once again, thank you for watching. I shall see you soon.